Good morning, reseller party people. It is early Friday morning, April 17th. And when I was uploading a video a day or two ago, I realized I had completely neglected to upload two or three days of sales from last week. I guess life got in the way. I know I had posted a couple of different videos, but somehow I neglected some sales from specifically Thursday and Friday of last week. I was just going to move past it, just delete them, and just keep current. Usually when I post videos, I'm within a day or two of my current sales. So everything is, as I post, it's really up to date and current. But when I was flipping through the videos I shot, I thought there was some pretty cool stuff in there that I should show you guys. I thought you might find a lot of that stuff interesting. Some of it's the same old stuff, guitar strings and all that, that I sell just about every day. But there were some cool sales that I wanted to show you and that I thought you might find interesting. So this video, I am posting it today, Friday the 17th. But it is actually 2 days of sales, Thursday and Friday of last week, which is the 9th and the 10th of April. So, enjoy.
Raindrops keep falling on my head. And just like the guy whose feet are too big for his bed, nothing seems to fit though. Raindrops are falling on my head, they keep falling. So I just did me some talking to the
sun. It is pouring rain. It is Thursday morning. Pouring rain. Got, I think, about 16, 17 things to ship out this morning. Glad I work inside.
One, two.
It is Thursday morning, and we've got about 20 things to ship out for about $215. So let's get into it. First thing going out is a another item that I picked up at the liquidation auction site that I purchased stuff from a lot. And these are brand new. I believe they're Amazon returns. I'm not sure, but they are brand new, flawless. And it was a group of wetsuits. I think I bought about six or seven of them for a total of about $25. So there's about $4 or $5 into each one of them. And I have a child's wetsuit listed right now for like $18. And then I had a full body, large adult wetsuit listed. I still have to list the other ones. But the adult wetsuit just sold for $49. And like I said, I have about $4 into it. If even that, I don't even know if I have that much money into it. But approximately $4. Luckily the person lives in California, so I'm able to ship that priority mail for less than $8. It's like $7.50 based on the weight. So they'll get it probably tomorrow. So all in shipping and everything, my costs are about $12 plus eBay fees. But like I said, I sold it for $49. I think $49.50 is what I sold it for. So I'm going to profit after fees. Well, $30, $35 after fees, maybe $30. I'll profit on that. And it's a very similar wetsuit to that one. Like I said, it's a full body wetsuit. And brand new condition. There's no tags or anything, but you can tell they are brand new, never used. And just sold them as new other. And it is going out today. And my buyer, because he's real close to me, will probably have that tomorrow. And next items going out are, like you see me sell just about every day, are these acoustic guitar strings from Dean Markley. Today I have 7 individual orders for 1 set, and then I have 2 orders for 2 sets each. So I have 11 orders of these going out for $5.29. Next thing I sold today is another retail pack of 100 of these clear poly outer sleeves to put your records in, keep them dust free and safe. I sell these for $17.95, so I got 1 order of those going out today. Next item going out today is a pair of Simon Phillips signature drumsticks from Promark. These are going out the door, I think, for a little bit less than $12 free shipping. Simon Phillips, as you may or may not know, replaced Jeff Porcaro in Toto, and he's played with like tons of other people. I think he's filled in for The Who, and I think I saw like Tears for Fears on his Wikipedia page, stuff like that. So, a legendary drummer, been around and played with everybody. So then sold a decent amount of records today, which is good. I'm happy about that. First thing going out the door is a copy of Stevie Wonder's Part-Time Lover 7-inch single. And this is going out the door for $4.99. Next record going out today is an original press of the band King and their album Steps in Time. Kind of cool. Still got the original Tower Records price sticker on there. It's got the hype sticker on there. This album played great. If you're looking at this album and going, who is King? They had that hit single Love and Pride, which was all over the radio. I still hear it on pop radio, alternative radio. Great song, and it was everywhere. Huge hit for them. I don't think they did anything after that. But anyway, this is going out the door for $9. Another record going out today is a copy of Huey Lewis and the News album Sports, and this is an original press from 1983, and you might be surprised to know this album sells all the time. I know over the years, this is probably like the 10th or 15th copy of this album I have found and stuff, found in my boxes, and it always sells, and it always sells fast. I've had this one listed for maybe a couple days, and it's going out the door today for $10. Then the next order I have going out is actually one person bought a quantity of 3 records, 2 used and 1 brand new. And the first one he bought is the Go-Go's Vacation, and I believe that one sold for $4. The next one is from a kind of new wavy band, Level 42, and I think that one sold for $3. And then I have a sealed version, a sealed copy of Courtney Barnett and Kurt Vile's album, what is it? A Lot of Sea Lice is the name of it. And when I got this one, it showed up with a little bit of wear right there, so I couldn't charge full retail. So I sold this one out the door for $16 plus shipping. But because he bought all 3 of these albums together, he actually gets a shipping discount. So he's getting all 3 of these records for $29. What a deal. Just album going out is from Los Angeles heavy metal legends Lizzie Borden, and this is a 2018 reissue limited edition on opaque blue slate vinyl. And this is going out the door for $27. It is Friday, and I've got about 20 things going out the door today for a grand total of about $180. So let me show you what's going out. This thing going out, as usual, is a whole bunch of guitar strings. I've got one set of these D'Addario Phosphor Bronze acoustic guitar strings, and they're going out the door for $750. Then I had five individual buyers purchase one set each of these Dean Markley acoustic guitar strings. And then I had another buyer purchase two sets, and I sell each of these sets for $529. So they are going out the door. All right, then I had one buyer purchase two sets. These are actually my last two pairs of the Simon Phillips signature drumsticks from Promark. And he got a discount for buying both pairs at the same time. So it worked out to about, I think, $750 per set. So he paid about $15 for these. And then I have a handful of their refrigerator magnets. I've already bubble wrapped it. But they're pretty funny. They're like these retro designs. And this one says, I like my men like I like my coffee, ground up and put in the freezer. Pretty funny. And I sell these for $4.99. So with shipping, everything, the two pairs of drumsticks and the magnet plus shipping, he's all in for about $26 going out the door. All right, next thing's going out. I have a whole bunch of music going out the door today. And it's weird how things are kind of cyclical. I won't sell very many CDs or whatever. And then all of a sudden it'll click in. And like overnight I'll sell like a whole bunch. So that's what happened last night. I sold a whole bunch of CDs just like out of nowhere. So first one going out the door is a compilation CD from the Sub Pop record label up in Seattle. And it's a two disc compilation just featuring a bunch of the bands on that label. And this is going out the door for $5. And then the next CD going out, I actually just listed, I think like a couple days ago, along with another CD that sold. And this is from Pharrell. And it is called In My Mind. Features a bunch of guest artists like Gwen Stefani, Jay-Z, Kanye West. People like that. And this is going out the door for $5. Next CD is from Ira Stein and Russell Walder. And it's from the Windham Hill label. So it's kind of progressive, easy listening, kind of modern jazz stuff. And this CD is kind of hard to find. And this CD is kind of hard to find, and it is going out the door for $7. Then I had a person pick up a group of three CDs, all of which are kind of scarce. First one is from the goth punk band Christian Death. Band All About Eve. I believe this CD is out of print. And Miranda Sex Garden. And I think that CD is out of print also. So all three CDs that this guy picked up are rare / out of print. And he got all three of those. Because I offer a discount when you buy, my discount right now is you buy two, you get one free. So he got a really good deal on three pretty rare CDs. And these are all going out the door for $15, including shipping. What a deal. And the last CD going out today is actually a two disc box set. featuring opera singer Maria Callas and La Traviata. And pretty cool set. Comes obviously with the slipcase. Pretty big booklet. Really cool. I'm sure this was pretty expensive when it came out. This still has the price sticker on it from when I had it at the store, and I was trying to sell it for $9.99. So it's old stock of mine from back when we had the store. So, and I let this go on eBay for $8 plus shipping. So a total of $11 going out the door. I have one trading card going out today. It is a 1992 Topps Oakland Raiders Willie Gault card. I actually have, I think, I had three or four of them. So I just put them up as a multi-item listing. And I think this is the second one out of the three or four that I've sold. And it's going out the door for a dollar. I have two records going out today, which is a little disappointing. I've been trying to list a little bit more, trying to get some of that stuff up there. But this is one I actually listed a day or two ago from Men at Work and their classic album, Business as Usual. It's got all their hits on it. Well, all their original hits. Who Can It Be Now? You know, that kind of stuff. Land Down Under or whatever. All those classic new wave pop songs. Album played great. The sleeves got some issues. The top had a seam split, so I couldn't really price it real high. So this is going out the door for $3 plus shipping, so $7 total on its way out. And then last record going out, I actually bought a handful of these. This is Mike Watt and his legendary band, the Minutemen, kind of classic punk rock stuff here. And like I said, I bought a handful of these, I think about a year ago, and it just seems like every 3 or 4 months I sell one. So I've slowly been whittling my way through these. After this one goes out the door, I think I have one left, and this is going out the door for, let me double check. Yeah, so this one's going out the door for $23. And next thing going out, hurts a little bit. Hurts a little bit to ship this one out and see it go. If you remember a video I made, I was going to start making a whole series of videos featuring 7-inch singles every Sunday, playing clips from the 7-inches. And then after I did it, I don't know, I saw a video on YouTube or something, and the guy was talking about getting copyright strikes and that kind of stuff. So I changed my mind on that. I was like, oh, maybe I shouldn't do that. And then as you can tell by some of my more recent videos, I said, screw that. Nobody watches my videos anyway. Might as well play clips of music that I like, and it makes the videos a little bit more fun to watch, I think. So I don't know, so we'll see what happens. Hey, if I end up in jail... If I end up doing a perp walk because I put some random music on my YouTube channel. I don't know. We'll see what happens. Anyway, yes, it is sad to see this one go. This was featured in that episode of 7 Inches on Sunday that I might restart. I might start doing that again just because I don't care. I mean, we'll see what happens. If I get contacted from YouTube or something, then I'll stop. But I might bring that back. I only did one episode, so it's not really bringing it back. I might restart it. So anyway, I digress. In an episode of 7 Inches on Sunday, I featured two surf rock bands, and this is one of them. This is the Rumblers. And if you remember, I just loved this disc. Loved it. Side A, a track called The Boss. Side B, oh, I Don't Need You No More, which is another great song. So both songs on this 7-inch are just great. Really hard to find, really rare. I think when I listed this, I was either the only one who had this up on eBay, or one of two people. I think I was the only person that had this listed. So like I said, really hard to find. Great surf rock from the early 60s. I think it came out in 61 or 62 on the Downey record label from Downey, California. And anyway, this is going out to a buyer from Germany who purchased this for, I believe, $18.50. And then he is also paying $15 in international shipping. So he's paying, what, $33.50 total to get this 7-inch single shipped from Orange County, California to Germany. So whoever you are, if you're watching from Germany, thank you. I hope you'll enjoy it. I know I did. So like I said, it sucks to see this thing go out the door. But it will be on its way to Germany. All right, that is it for this video. From this point forward, we should be all caught up to date and current. Thanks a lot for watching. I really appreciate it. Hopefully, you guys found some of those things I sold interesting and cool as I did. And if you're new to the channel, please like and subscribe. I really appreciate it. And leave me a comment. Let me know you're out there. That's always appreciated, and we will catch you on the flip side. Thanks a lot.